In this video tutorial, I am going to discuss about oxidase and oxygenase. See, these are two similar looking names, right? Why similar looking names? Because they have certain common characteristic, and because of that similar names are given. The first common characteristic is that both oxidase and oxygenase both belongs to the enzyme commissions class number 1. And what is the name of this first class? As I told you in the previous video, it is oxidoreductase. So, both belongs to oxidoreductase class of enzyme. The second common characteristic is that both oxidase and oxygenase, they require molecular oxygen in their reaction. So, these two similar aspects are there between oxidase and oxygenase. Now, let us look at the difference between oxidase and oxygenase. So, let us first look at the oxidase. Now, remember, oxidase is not a name of single enzyme, rather it is actually a group of enzyme which has certain common characteristic. Now, to understand that what type of reactions are catalyzed by the oxidase, let us consider substrate AH₂. So, AH₂, it undergoes oxidation, so it loses its hydrogen atoms and gets converted to product A. Now, this hydrogen atom, they react with the molecular oxygen, as I told you, that common thing that they require molecular oxygen. So, here this molecular oxygen, it takes away these hydrogen atoms and gets converted to either hydrogen peroxide or water molecule, depending on the reaction and depending on the number of hydrogens are being lost, right? So, here as I told you in the previous video tutorial, that whenever in any reaction, if hydrogen atoms are being lost, we call that as a oxidation reaction. That means this product A is the oxidized product, right? So, here the hallmark feature of the reaction which is being catalyzed by the oxidase is that molecular oxygen, of course, it is participating, but it is not appearing in this final oxidized product. So, when you see any such reaction, it will be definitely catalyzed by the oxidase enzyme. So, what we can say about oxidase? That oxygen atoms does not appear in oxidized product. Once again, what is the oxidized product over here? It is this one. And oxygen atom does not appear. So, is this oxygen atoms are appearing in this oxidized product? No. So, this reaction is catalyzed by the oxidase, right? Now, generally it is observed that most of oxidase enzyme, remember I am talking about most, not all. So, most of the oxidase enzyme are flavoproteins. As this flavoprotein is not followed by all the oxidase enzyme, I cannot say it as a hallmark feature. What is the hallmark feature? It is this one, that oxygen atoms does not appear in the oxidized product. The examples of oxidase enzymes are the cytochrome C oxidase and monoamine oxidase. So, this was oxidase, its action is very straightforward. Now, let us look at the oxygenase. So, the second is oxygenase. Now, oxygenase are different from the oxidase in a way that oxygen atoms appear in the oxidized product. In case of oxidase, what was there? That oxygen atom does not appear in the oxidized product. Whereas, in case of oxygenase, what is happening? It is that oxygen atoms appear in oxidized product, right? So, this is only the difference, primary difference between oxidase and oxygenase. So, now there are two possibilities for the oxygenase. What are these two possibilities? As I told you that oxygen atoms are being appearing in the oxidized product. Now, if you consider molecular oxygen, it is two oxygen atoms, right? So, there are two possibilities that from this one molecular oxygen, only one oxygen atom appear in this finalized oxidized product, then we can call it as a monooxygenase, mono oxygenase. And if from this molecular oxygen, two oxygen atoms are appearing in the final oxidized product, we can call them as a dioxygenase. So, there are two types or two subgroups of this oxygenase. It can be monooxygenase or dioxygenase. Monooxygenase, when only one oxygen atom from the molecular oxygen is appearing in the oxidized product. And other one is the dioxygenase. That means two oxygen atoms from the molecular oxygen is appearing in the oxidized product. Let's look at this monooxygenase and the dioxygenase one by one. So, now the first is the monooxygenase. Now, if you look at the generalized reaction catalyzed by the monooxygenase, so for that, suppose we have this substrate AH₂. Now, if this AH₂ is being catalyzed by the monooxygenase, what will happen? From this molecular oxygen, only one oxygen atom will be inserted in this substrate. So, what will happen? AH and another hydrogen atom will generally form OH. So, as you can see that from this two oxygen atom from this molecular oxygen, only one oxygen atom is being inserted into this substrate, and so final oxidized product contain only one oxygen atom. Right. Now, what happens to another oxygen atom? So, another oxygen atom will be converted to water molecule. So, this second oxygen atom will appear in the water molecule. Now, the question will be, from where does these two hydrogen atoms are coming? So, these two hydrogen atoms are actually donated by another substrate which has extra two hydrogen atoms, right? So, AX2, X, suppose let us say the second substrate is the XH2, right? Now, what happens? These two hydrogen atoms are being donated to this single oxygen atom and gets converted to water, and this XH2 gets converted to this second product, that is X. So, what this second product could be? So, mostly this second product is going to be FMNH2 or FADH2 or NADH plus H plus or NADPH plus H plus, or it can be other thing also. It can be other thing, like it can be alpha ketoglutarate or tetrahydrobiopterin. So, this other coenzyme, we can say coenzyme, can participate in this monooxygenase. Now, here one more important thing is that this final oxidized substrate, after getting one molecular oxygen, they generally create this hydroxyl group. And because of that, this monooxygenase, they are also called as a hydroxylase. They are also known as hydroxylase. The second important thing is that this two molecular oxygen, from this molecular oxygen, one oxygen atom is appearing in the final oxidized product and another oxygen atom is being lost as a water molecule. So, here as you can see, this oxygen atoms are being mixed up in this final oxidized product as well as this reduced product also. So, because of that reason, it is also called as a mixed function oxygenase. And surprisingly, many times instead of mixed function oxygenase, it is also called as a mixed function oxidase. Isn't it surprise? Here there is in the name there is an oxidase, but it is not from the oxidase, rather it is from the oxygenase. If you remember, oxidase is a different thing that I talked to you initially, right? So, that is the thing that you must remember, that if sometime it is written that mixed function oxidase, don't consider it is from the class oxidase, rather it is from the oxygenase. Now, in general or in nature, what happens? This monooxygenase are more abundant, okay? They are more abundant in nature. And as you can also see that this substrate are participating in the reaction, we can easily understand that this monooxygenase's enzyme action is the more complex. So, their mechanism is more complex in nature. Let's look at the examples of oxygenases. All the cytochrome P450 enzymes are from this monooxygenase. Remember, cytochrome P450 enzyme, it is actually a family of enzyme. There are several hundred of enzymes are there in this cytochrome P450 enzyme. Another examples are aldosterone synthase, then we have 21 hydroxylase and 11 hydroxylase. So, these all are the examples of monooxygenase. Now, let us look at the dioxygenase. Now, dioxygenase is very simple. Here, both oxygen atoms from the molecular oxygen are being inserted into the final oxidized product. So, suppose we have this substrate AH2. Now, what happens if this AH2 substrate, this reaction is being catalyzed by the dioxygenase, then one molecular oxygen comes in and both oxygen atoms are being inserted into this substrate. So, what will happen? AH2, and it will contain both oxygen atom in the final product. Generally, these are the ring breaking reaction. What does it mean? Generally, because the substrate is going to contain some ring. Suppose let's say it contains benzene ring, and final product, this benzene ring will be opened like this. This will be bound with the oxygen, this will be bound with the oxygen. So here now the ring will be in the open conformation. This is the general thing, it is not a rule. Okay. Now let us look at the example. What are the examples of dioxygenase? One is tryptophan dioxygenase. Tryptophan dioxygenase and lipoxygenase. So, this was about the dioxygenase. Now, if you just look at the overview, see, in the oxidase enzyme, how many oxygen atoms are appearing in the final oxidase product? That is zero. No any oxygen atoms are appearing in the final oxidase product. In case of monooxygenase, how many oxygen atoms are appearing in this final oxidase product? One. So, here one. And in case of dioxygenase, how many oxygen from the molecular oxygen appears in the final oxidized product? Two. So, the difference is very straightforward and very simple. In oxidase, it is zero. Monooxygenase, it is one. And dioxygenase, it is two. So, this completes our discussion about oxidase and oxygenase, and I hope that now onwards you will not have any confusion between differentiating oxidase, monooxygenase and dioxygenase. If you still have any query or confusion, please write it down in the comment section below. Thank you.